Hello, I'm Marilyn Allis. I'm going to show you how to paint a scene from Covent Garden. It has lovely memories of the music and the atmosphere, and we're going to capture that. But first I'm going to mix up lots of washes and get those on. I use a big whopper brush because I want to do that very quickly. I'm going to mix some raw sienna, some cadmium orange, and a mix of intense violet with some raw sienna. Just make sure that you mix up plenty of wash before you start. You don't want to run out halfway through. So apply them quickly. First of all, the light raw sienna wash is going on. I'm trying to keep some light in here with some contrast as well. If you look at the photograph, there isn't a lot of contrast between this wall and the other wall. And what I want to do is create that. So I'm going to make the wall on the left-hand side orange, and that will give me the sort of atmosphere of the actual music and what was going on there. Right, the floor colour is just slightly darker, so that can be the mauve that's mixed in with the raw sienna. I can go straight over any legs that are dark. Just making sure that I don't leave any bits of the floor out. And there's a bit of wall up here that's quite dark, so this can be the mixture of intense violet and raw sienna too. And then I'll just add a little bit of ultramarine to that, just to push back these people in the distance at the very back. And whilst that's still wet, I want to do some of the archways. So with a slightly smaller brush, I'm using some burnt umber and a little bit of the orange. I want to catch that whilst it's still wet so it runs a little bit. I don't want a solid line going down there. And it's quite dark, the archway over the top, so just a tiny bit of sepia added into that. And that just gives you a little bit of a darker tone. Just pull in any areas where there are white gaps, because we don't want those later. And just do that with a damp brush and just pull the colour in to the musicians. And now we have to leave that to dry. Right, now our paint's completely dry, I can now put in the musicians. They're going to be our main focal points, so I'm going to put those in next. I'm making a mix of light red with a tiny bit of sepia. I'm just going to put all the flesh tones in of all of them first. As you can see, I've used a different drawing of the person playing the cello, mainly because on the photograph that you can see, he's standing up with it, and that would look really odd. So I've just placed another picture of him when he was actually sitting down. I'm just taking out some of the lighter areas with clear water on my brush. I'm just using the SAA All Rounder. And now the hair tones can go in, so a little bit of sepia for each one of those. So I do want them to be quite dark and to stand out. And now the clothes. So Prussian blue mixed with sepia will give us a lovely dark. And just to vary it a little bit for the trousers, I use just Prussian blue on its own. And some dry brush marks to create the movement. And add a little bit of sepia into that again for the shoes. Right on to the next person. A little bit of intense violet for his hat. For his t-shirt. And some cobalt blue just on its own for his trousers. And the guy on the end's wearing red, which will again make him very much a focal point. And so we'll leave that red in. And put the shadows in once that's dry. And his trousers can be cobalt blue too. While the light's hitting it, I'm just putting some clear water and then we can put the darker bits in later. Now whilst that's drying, well, I'll show you how to create a crowd of people very, very quickly. I'm going to use some ultramarines. We'll use some burnt umbers in a minute and just put the shapes of the people in as quick as you can. A little bit of Prussian blue. That person's got his leg sort of up at a nice angle, which will look good. This one's bending too. You can run the colours next to each other. Just do them really, really quickly. Here you can't really see what's going on, so just lines coming down. Maybe a skirt. I'll put some burnt umber into that. And red always looks really good, so some alizarine crimson. And for the skin tones, we just use the light red and the sepia. So legs and some faces. A few more legs going in. And some hair, just a little touch or dots of sepia onto some of the heads. There, we've painted about 30 people in 10 seconds. Now we can do the musical instruments. So I'm going to use a burnt umber with a little bit of light red. Just put the shapes that you can see that they're making. A very pale wash over the cello. Lighten that even more. And I'll feed into that some light red. And a little bit of intense violet for the sheet music. It's white, but that's in a lot of shadow.